Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Monday evening. And we're going to pick up in BioShock Remastered, which I started this past Friday. So hopefully you all had a good weekend. Hopefully you're all staying safe, staying healthy, trying not to get the plague, trying not to die because of government stupid. So we'll be doing this until 9 o'clock. So speaking of government stupid and what happens when capitalism runs amok, let's dive into stream number 2 of my BioShock playthrough. We are in Neptune's Bounty to start off tonight. After having just taken care of the crazed Dr. Jim Steinman. Utterly out of stuff. I need health badly. What am I doing on weapons? Oh yes, I desperately need. I hear a Big Daddy, but I am in too horrible of shape. Way too horrible of a shape to,
Welcome to the Circus of Value!
Yep. Definitely needed to get some. Alright, well, waste not, want not. Take a while. All right, let's get our hacking on. Good. That should do it. Really? Okay. Now then. All right, mildly drunk. I just started, so at the moment, Wing, yes, I am. I'm just trying to get through. There's a lot of security cameras in this area, so I'm trying to just navigate my way through them. Goddammit. not fun when you take a grenade to the face. Take some chocolate. Chocolate is good. I hear ya. Let's hack the turret. Because I need to do that right now. Enough of this crap here. Kill. Oh! Did not see that one hiding there. Not that time. That takes care of one. It's partially my problem. This horse shit. There's some. I love how they give you the option to search the cameras if there's gonna be anything in it. I hear you. I wasn't done with this area yet. Didn't want to do that, but you left me no choice. Ooh! Dollars. Game some more. Okay, I like that. I like that. I like where that's going, and alright. Nice. I could do it with you. Thank you. Toilet, I want the bandages. I hear Big Daddy. Oh! Freaking minefield of turn. insurance. It's like, jeez, just let me get a freaking break here. Thank you. Who's hitting me now? No, you're good there. I hacked you. You're hacked. Did I miss one? Must have. You're hacked. Searched. Go away. Audio diary?
Hanging now, is it? That's what we've come to. Now look, I don't make the laws here. I just enforce them. But I didn't come to Rapture to string men up for running contraband. If Ryan and his crew have their law, then they can have my badge.
Alright. What's in the safe? Jesus. Some slow moving goop. No. Thank you. Yo. What do we got? We got a lot of cash, is what we got. And a lot of evidence. And I hear the Big Daddy again. It's like, no. Ah! Well, I think I'm good for the moment. Out of shotgun. Maxed out on shotgun. Should probably switch up some of that. I'm maxed out on machine gun rounds. Goody. Interrogation room.
Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong. They are weak, but he is strong.
Oh, come on, then.
Father, why have you forsaken me?
Nice. Oh, good to know.
His light shineth even down here in the murk.
You'll open up if you want for you.
We have turned away from your light.
I just saw some cake. Cake. I want some cake.
All his
why do you always do this?
Someone's office, okay.
You think I'm sorry.
There, I'll take the cream filled cake.
We thought we could hide from the light down here.
Oh, goody.
I'm just lonely.
Yes.
I'm lonely.
Yes, he is, tiny dragon. Ah. I wish I had that earlier. Winter Blast, Incinerate. I haven't really used telekinesis a whole lot, so let's swap out.
Trick the security system. Set security bots and turrets on your enemies.
So let's do that right now. Save my ammo. Beautiful. That was fun. Oh, I love them too. Full on a bunch of ammo. Oh, this is a lot of fun, Tiny Dragon. Can I hack it? Yes. This particular game changed my opinion on first-person shooters. I thought, for most of my life, really, that they were just kind of one note. I mean, really, the only experience I had had with first-person shooters as a kid was basically in the form of Duke Nukem and Doom. So, not really a whole lot of masterful storytelling in a game like that. So when I saw, definitely Tiny Dragon, when this game, when the trailer came out, I was so curious. I was so curious about the story, and this is probably one of the most tragically beautiful games I've ever played. And yes, Wing says it perfectly. There's so much story. There is a prequel novel that is official canon. Oh, I gotta move quick on this one. Shit, that's gonna suck. No, it won't. No, yes, it will. Try that again. That's what I wanted the first time. Shit, shit, shit. Damn it. Get there in time. Come on. Yes.
Bienvenido al amo bandido.
Muchas gracias. It's a tragic story to see what happens to a society and a civilization and an ideology when capitalism runs completely amok. That is the basic premise of this game. It's a man by the name of Andrew Ryan, who you'll see a lot throughout this entire game. In the late 1950s, he wants to build a society to get away from government, to get away from regulation, and also coming on the heels of the end of World War I, he's also scared that society is going to annihilate itself. So he creates this undersea capitalist utopia where it's capitalism at completely unregulated. It is capitalism at its truest form. No regulation, nothing. No safety net. And it lasted maybe a decade before people who came to Rapture figured this out, gamed the system, and just completely destroyed everything about it. And now we have an audio diary about the discovery of Adam. Ah, there's a big daddy. I'm not going to deal with him at the moment. I want another audio diary.
If things weren't bad enough, it seems that even our water system sprung a leak. Yep, that's right. You have the research camera? Good. Guess it's time to get to work for old Peachy. Take the man's pictures, and let's get the hell out of this place.
I wasn't done listening to the audio diary, Atlas.
If things weren't bad enough, it seems that even our water system sprung a leak. Yep, that's right. Irrigation system in Arcadia is taking on seawater. I told Mr. Ryan when we were building this place, either you build her like a bathtub, or she's gonna turn into a sewer. No, McDonough, he said. We're not going to build no bathtub. We're going to build Eden.
Okay. But yes, it is incredibly atmospheric. It's so beautiful. And this is... what I'm playing is the remastered version of the game, which is... this was released, I think, last year, to mark its to mark its 10th anniversary. Let's see how I'm gonna navigate my way out of this one. Thank you. closer. Shit. Ah, thank God. Yeah, I've started playing this game. I mean, this was the game I wanted. I bought this version of the game about 3 years ago when it came out, because I played the original, loved it, and wanted to see how gorgeous they made the remaster. And it crashed my computer, because my poor old graphics card in my old computer could not handle it. The graphics card just could not take it. It would shut my monitor right off. This was the game that finally spurred me to actually build my new PC. I hear ya. These puzzles, Tiny Dragon, have you ever played the old, it was just an old puzzle game for the NES called Pipe Dream? I know I'm severely dating myself by saying that, but yes, this is what that reminds me of. See, the bot's doing its thing. Well done. Straight edge. Oh, right. I actually need to take pictures. Did I actually get that? Yeah. Oh. You can't shoot dead ones. Okay.
Judas!
There we go. Enough of this. You're out. Now, question. I'm like, how do I get out of this? Convenient. Take your money. I think I'm good on the gene bank. Yep. So any machine that is hackable in this game, Tiny Dragon, has a level of difficulty, which you can see by the meter here. I do. I love doing these puzzles. Although sometimes, if they're really, really difficult, I need to get a shift on here. If they're really difficult, you find throughout the course of the game, auto hack tools. Like if they are really hard, that'll either mean there's a lot of these little trap things. Which I just noticed I couldn't get out of that last one. All right. Or the ooze will flow very quickly. There we go. And in the case of a vending machine, if you hack it, it lowers the cost of everything. Tap, tap for RC Beer Ale, tastiest beer in town. Just a lot of these details are much more clear in the remaster than in the original.
Hold it, buddy.
Oh, nice. You're on fire. You shouldn't still be shooting at me. There you go. We have an audio diary.
I'm closing in on the whole ring. I'd pat myself on the back, but let's face it, these aren't exactly bloodthirsty desperados we're talking about. Rapture's full of poets, artists, and tennis players, not hired gorillas. But this leader of theirs, this Fontaine, he seems to know his way around the grift. He keeps his nose clean, but not so clean. Right people don't know he's not to be trifled with.
$4 in the register, okay. I hear a big daddy. Zap the water. Zap again. Should take care of them. Something I like to do in this, I like to hack the health stations because sometimes the enemies will try to go to a health station to heal, and if you hack them, when the enemy goes to use a health station to heal, it'll actually hurt them. It'll heal you. Damn it. It'll heal you, but it'll hurt them. And just the amount of things that you can interact with. And the way they give you the backstory of a lot of the NPC characters in the form of the audio diaries is really, really cool. I mentioned the prequel novel to this. A number of the NPCs you hear in the audio diaries, they are main point of view characters in the prequel. And it fleshes out the game so much more. Not required reading, but definitely enhances it. hack the security camera, why not? Oh, nice. I that's a really nifty mechanic. Wine cellar. Just hack you. Take your money. Oh, no spoilers, Wing, because I know you're watching this and you've beaten the game too. Do not spoil Tiny Dragon on Fire with probably one of the greatest plot twists in the history of video games comes in this game. I need to photograph three spider slicers. Okay. I was gonna say, I'm like, where the hell are you? So, little things like this. Like, the man who created this city, Rapture. Like, again, altruism, empathy, collectivism are all, he hates everything. Everything is all about individualism, all about self-profit, profit a man creates. A parasite asks, where is my share? Like, it is, the character of Andrew Ryan is very, very heavily based on Ayn Rand. Yes! Atlas Shrugged was a major inspiration for Andrew Ryan in this game, the creator of this city. Very good.
We tricked you, monster.
Don't not take her from me!
Come on.
Are you afraid of me, monster?
Was that the Yes, it was. Harry took that one. Oh!
Head on back to Fontaine Fisheries when you're ready. Would you guide me?
Oh, you got me! the last Vita chamber. Well, I mean, with very gr- oh, there's an. Gotcha. Spider splicer. Yes. Yes, it is. All right. Another audio diary, this time regarding the death penalty in Rapture.
The death penalty in Rapture. Council's in an uproar. Rights and streets, they say. But this is the time for leadership. Action must be taken against the smugglers. Any contact with the surface exposes Rapture to the very parasites we fled from. Stretched necks or a small price to pay for our ideals.
I did not, Tiny Dragon. I did not know such a song existed. Oh crap, 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 oh. We've got some fast moving slug. Damn it! Dead end, dead end. Okay, that just bought me a second. There we go. Yes, thank you, bot, for telling me I need to drink. So I'm going to drink. Was not done exploring this area. You absolutely can. I'm still figuring out the bot, so hopefully it doesn't flag it, but if it does, just message it to me. Nope, there it is. Okay. Whoa, there's a camera. Time. I want to take that camera out. Take some dollars. More dollars. I will give that a listen when I am done here, Tiny Dragon. And before I jump on to your stream, which I know you'll be starting very soon. Winged, if you're watching, Tiny Dragon on Fire is a marvelous, marvelous artist and all-around good person. So, I feel a sense of great ease when I catch one of her streams. So, yes, I was just saying that, Tiny Dragon. I will see you in a little more than an hour. Took out telekinesis. So. Come here, you. I will take that cream-filled cake. All right. I hear Big Daddy again. I'll take that hypo. Where are you? 'Cause I hear you. Oh! Nice. But I don't need to go all crazy on you right now. Quiet your footsteps and increase the melee damage on... no, actually, I'm good. Let's store that in the gene bank. No! Damn it! Well, it actually took me to exactly where I needed to go. All right. Two fewer overload tiles when hacking. Now I'll store in the gene bank for the moment. Alright. I am now unarmed. I love how they don't consider the wrench a weapon, though. That's fun. I'll have to get you later. Oh, that's not good. Come on, Peach. Yeah. bit. Let's take a couple of those right now. No. You stop it! Well, this isn't good. Yep. I tripped the security. All right. Really? God damn it. There. Jerks. We'll make this thing my friend. Because I could use a friend. There we go. Sure. I'll hack more. Jerks. Good, good. I don't know, but I need health and badly. Oh. is going to be fun. Yes, I know I'm wounded. Thanks, Napoleon. Oh, thank you. I hear ya. I am loving this thing more and more. Take you. Oh, good, good, good. Get my hypos back. Melt you a little bit. Melt you. Activate you. Oh. Oh, that's not pleasant. I don't know why I did that, but all right. Oh, right. I'm so sick and frickin' tired of that one bot. Jerk. That'll do. Thank you. Just to give you some good old-fashioned nightmare fuel. extra cripsy. Very good. Melt some more stuff. See what else I can find here. How about some nice fish? Because fish is... like, everything else is... Everything is so interactive in this game. You should be able to just interact with the fish. Alright. Got all my weapons back. Why does my phone keep vibrating? Who wants me? Ooh. Oh! I forgot about the power to the people benches. All right. You know what? Winged, you're on here. Which one of these do you think I should get? I'll leave the choice to you. Which one of these upgrades do you think I should get? Or if anyone else is in the chat, feel free to chime in. It's the first weapons upgrade, so... I'm leaning toward machine gun or... Yeah, I was leaning toward machine gun or pistol. Those seem to be the weapons I've been using the most. But machine gun it is. Apparently, director's commentary is an unlockable. Okay. All right, before I continue that away. We've got an audio diary. Let's take a listen.
Fontaine's putting the screws on us and double. He's squeezing us out of 80 points of our cut with the threat of turning us into Ryan if we don't play ball. Son of a bitch. Sammy G comes and tells me he's thinking of going to the constable. And the next day, Sammy G was found in a sack in a salt pond. We had no choice here. We stay on Fontaine's crew and we're gonna catch the gallows. We take powder and we end up like Sammy G. Oh, there's gotta be another way.
Oh, a bunch of Bibles frozen in the fridge. Alright. Ooh, this could be a little tricky. Shit. Oh, that's gonna be a... That just fucked me. Now that I know that's a hack. shit! Oh. Oh! Oh, that was luck. Ooh, the automatic hack tool. Love those. Okay. Oh, that was way too close. shit. All right. Now to go through the secret passage.
You got it. Should be smooth sailing from here. I'll meet you up ahead.
Ooh, we're getting into the smuggler's hideout. Chips. Search the crates. Oh, I love those.
I'm right outside the submarine bay, but I can't get in. I need you for that. My family can't be more than 100 yards away.
Sure, I'll take some drunk. Yeah, I see ya. I don't have enough money to do an auto hack. I want to save my whopping $12. Shotgun, hypo, pistol. Meeting with Fontaine. We have an audio diary.
We all come down here. Figured we all be part of Ryan's great chain. Turns out Ryan's chain is made of gold, and ours are the sort with the big iron ball around your ankle. He's up in Fort Frolic banging fashion models. We're down in this dump yanking guts out of fish. Fontaine's promising something better. He's like one of us, you know? Like he's worked a day in his life. He says meet him at his fish packing joint at 11. I'll go, bring a couple of guys. Hey, it's not like things could get a lot worse.
Oh, Peachy. Oh, way drunk. That was a lot of drink. I haven't saved it at all at this point, so let's save it here.
Hit the switch up there in the control booth and let me in. I think it's time to shake hands and get acquainted.
You had your fun, but enough is enough. You press that button, you'll learn what it means to truly be my enemy.
Is my room? Yeah. Yeah, man. That's turning out to be rather an effective... That is becoming quite an effective combination here, and I hear a Big Daddy.
Like an assassin, and then you try to sneak out like a thief. You're no CIA spook. Who are you? Why have you come here? There's two ways to deal with a mystery. Uncover it, or eliminate it.
Well, that sucked. Although, when I played this the first time, this was the point where I really, really started to despise Andrew Ryan. Which is the point, obviously. We have an audio diary to listen to.
The Irish pork pie offered me a deal. I flip him Fontaine and I walk out of here. That simple. How do I know that fat fuck isn't Fontaine's guy? How do I know they're not all Fontaine's guy? Fontaine's got Adam and everybody wants it. Ryan's got a whole lot of talk and a nice suit. Even down here, any idiot can see which way the wind is blowing.
To Arcadia we go. Because at this point, I mean, Atlas is your voice here, your lone guide, and Andrew Ryan is just... What the hell is his fucking deal?
Came to this place to build the impossible. You came to rob what you could never build. A hum gaping at the gates of Rome. Even the air you breathe is sponged from my account. Well, breathe deep, so later you might remember the case.
You get to the bathysphere in the rolling hills. That'll take you straight to the devil himself. Then all debts will be paid in full.
All right. So two little sisters in this level. Ooh, Proxim mines. That's attractive. I'll just take your $23. Gorgeous area, though, Tea Garden. This is actually really nice. Finding a lot of parts here. Thank you.
side effects of this plasmid business. One poor sod's memory is getting passed on to another through genetic sampling. Links. Lunatics. Rebellion. And now, bleeding ghosts. Ain't life in Rapture grand?
That's pleasant.
Hello.
The fuck? I appear to have forgotten something. The shit was that? Buttery fuck? Oh. I don't. But you know what? I would be remiss. Let's find out. I was already here, but I was, Who is Atlas? Who is John Galt? Oh, two of them. First, get over here, you jerk. Gotcha. And I'll take your $31 frickin' dollars. Ooh. Oh. Hypo. That's attractive.
What is it?
I'm top dog, you shit!
Take your pistol rounds, take that, and some of that.
Today, Arcadia was closed off to all but paying customers. The man hires me to build a forest at the bottom of the ocean and then turns a walk in the woods into a luxury. Riot asked, should a farmer not be able to sell his food? Is a potter not entitled to a profit from his pots? I started to argue with the man, and then I remembered who signed my checks. Only thing worse than a hypocrite is an unemployed one.
I do. I love this game's storytelling so goddamn much.
Where are you?
Come here now! Stop waiting for
me. Oh, accidental headshot. Nice. Find a U-invent machine. Okay. I want those machine gun rounds, though. Really? Fucking really? All right. Come on. Thank you. Let's go this way. Curve up. Other way, thank you. And good. Thank you for the Steam achievement for a skilled hacker. Clearly you saw something. Ah. Oh, I'm out of room for proximity mines. All right. I'll get to you in a minute. Yeah, but you're also dead. Let's start hacking this one. See if I can get some good value. Come on. Come on. You can do it. There we go. I think I'm good for the moment. We want to give you good old-fashioned nightmare fuel, Ryan. Be hearing that in your dreams. Thank you for tripping that for me. good. Sure, I'll take the coffee. Ooh. Can't take that. I can take the bandages, heal myself back up to full. And let's hack the... Ooh. Nope. I'm just going to use an auto hack for that one. And I think I was already here. Yes, I was. So that was the employees only. Okay, there's a bot up there.
Is someone toxic? Something unsanitary!
Or not. I'm down here. You're wasting your ammo.
Impressive.
Oh, another one of these idiots. Hey, I'll go to a U-Invent machine. You know what? Let's give it a try. Oh shit, that's moving fast. But still good. All right. You know what? I could do with the armor-piercing rounds. Because I'm sure there's going to be big daddies to deal with. Lovely. I still hear the fuckers. Ah, all right. Well, let's save that, because I have to get them. While you take care of that guy, I'll just take a picture. Kill him.
Now my turn. You missed. Get up. Close. Really? No. Oh, I hit a mine. Just hold still. I'm trying to save you here.
Even in Thank the gathering you. Dark, you light a candle. You have saved the little ones when you might have shown your cruelty. I am sending something your way to demonstrate our thanks.
Yes, good. All right. Ooh, another tonic. Hello, Rose. All right. We've got a lot of options here. Oh boy. Okay. First, I could probably do with some tonic slots. Just done. Done. Reduces difficulty. Yes, I'll take that. I'll take a combat tonic slot. Wrench lurker, static discharge, wrench lurker. Okay, no. I'll do that. Alright. Let's do... I've been using that electro bolt a lot. So, you know what? Let's upgrade it.
Time for belly by Mr. B.
Meanwhile, I need health, and I need it badly. So, not going to do anything for that. That's not going to do anything for my present problem. It's against the objectivism. Yes. That is exactly right. There's a hypo. Hacker's Delight. Yeah, sure. Before I head that way. Not done here yet. Audio diary, which we'll listen to in a minute. No, but, Rose, because it's survival of the fittest, the health only exists for the strongest. Because they've earned it. Or some such slop. Okay. See ya. There's a bot there. Couple of them. In all seriousness, Rose, they were probably, since everyone who came to Rapture was approved by Andrew Ryan, they were probably all people who had no problem dying for the economy. Much like our current plague. There are probably people who hated paying taxes, who hated collectivism, and who lacked empathy and, you know, helping your fellow man, and who worship money. Rose, I don't know if you've read the novel. There is a prequel novel that takes place before the game. It's officially canon, and it tells it's the prequel. It tells you how Rapture got built, and it's told from the point of view of several characters. It's told from the point of view of Andrew Ryan. Okay. Yeah. So. All right. Hold that thought. Like, I hate everything Andrew Ryan stands for, and I love how detailed this game's story is. It's one of the most tragic stories in a video game I've ever played. I don't feel sorry for Andrew Ryan at all. But it's like, as we're all seeing in the news about people who, you know, government saying that we should open the economy back up and how coronavirus in this country is really just a matter of political opinion. I'm very much reminded of this game.
There has been tremendous pressure to regulate this plasmid business. There have been side effects, blindness, insanity, death. But what use is our ideology if it is not tested? The market does not respond like an infant, shrieking at the first sign of displeasure. The market is patient, and we must be too.
Some more audio diaries.
Gregory, don't come whining to me about market forces, and don't expect me to punish citizens for showing a little initiative. If you don't like what Fontaine is doing, well, I suggest you find a way to offer a better product.
Yes, I know about the lockdown. It's absurd. Just give me a minute. These Lazarus tests are very promising. If the Rose
excellent. Whoa! Suddenly got a face first flamethrower. It's been happening to me a lot this game where it's just all like la 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 and then suddenly grenade to the face. The funny thing, Rose, when I played BioShock Infinite, that game made me far more uncomfortable than BioShock 1 and 2 ever did. Like, they're both absolutely horrible societies, but Columbia felt crueler, probably because it felt like, because Columbia was what happens when you fetishize the founding fathers and abject racism to the degree that it did. Like, seeing people like George Washington revered as a saint, like, I played that entire game and all I could think of was, this is the future that Fox News anchors want.
Hello.
One hundred percent agree with you, Rose, and I think that's why BioShock Infinite made me a lot more uncomfortable playing it, because it felt a lot closer to home. Like, you can pass off the first two especially the first BioShock game, you could absolutely pass it off as, you know, Ayn Rand fanfic. BioShock Infinite felt more plausible somehow. I saw that. So we have about 10 minutes more in tonight's stream, so we'll see if we can, I still have one more. Come on. Damn it! God damn it. Damn it! Damn it!
rabble could stand slack-jawed under the canopy and pretend that it was paradise earned. Congress moved to nationalize my forest. I burnt it to the ground. God did not plant the seeds of this Arcadia. I did.
I think I do. I just have to actually add it to my plasmid loadout. Good, I'll eat some potato chips. Hear ya. Oh, hello. I mean, I do have to get the second little sister that's in this level, so there it is. Well,
I can make them soft and sometimes I do.
Halfway down. Come on. Oh, those poor big daddies indeed, especially when you find out how they're made. All right. Well, I have to go back to them. Gotcha.
No, 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 no.
There's the two for the level.
Thank you. Thank you for helping me.
I'll take your $62. What the hell would a big daddy have carrying cash around? I'd like to know. I think that's gonna put me near the end of the level. But for the moment. Oh! No, I'm just gonna auto hack you. You're good. I'm not gonna bother you. I'm just exploring. Don't mind me. I'm just here for some... Just catching... Getting some preserves. That's all. All right. So I think right here is where I am going to stop for the night because it is 9 o'clock. So I will be picking this up again on Friday at 7:30. 7:30 to 10:30. So on that fun note, thank you to everyone who stopped by this evening. Always welcome. Absolutely a joy to have you around. And I hope you'll join me for Friday evening when we pick this up exactly right here. So have a good week. Stay healthy. Stay safe. Please do not fall victim to plague or to government stupid. We wouldn't want that because just no. So, all right. I'm Brian. I'll see you guys on Friday. Have a good night, everyone.